Hey guys, it's Carl here at Berry Country Club again. Great news. Today is finally a Canadian good day. It's 5 Celsius, but there's no wind. As you'll notice, none of the trees, well, they're moving, but not as much as always. So it's probably a little bit warmer than 5 degrees, but the ball is still going to be going 20% less than usual. So in the summer, it would be 300 yards is how far I'm hitting it. So that's minusing 60 yards if it's 20%. So 240 is what it should be. I won't be hitting a 240. I might be hitting a little further, but we'll see. So first hole, 450, par 4. Today it's into the wind, and it's also downhill, so it's probably playing 450. What a shot. That was nice and high and down the middle. Front pin, probably 160, 170 out into the green. This is a good opening drive. So according to Bushnell, I have 167. When I first got here to Berry, when it was a lot warmer, probably about 15 Celsius, I was a little windy, maybe downwind a little bit, but I was still getting up to the 100 yard marker, which is a 350 yard drive. Fairways were firmer, so I was getting roll. It was a little downwind, it was downhill, but still. Here, those are pins at the front too, so that's probably about a 75 yard difference from about 3 weeks ago when it was a lot warmer. But 167, I'm gonna play a 7 iron. And land it a little right, let it feed to the left. Into the wind, 7th not gonna get there. So I'm gonna hit a 6. And do the same thing, land it right. Let the slope bring it in. There's also a little right to left wind here. That should assist it. Six was the right club there. Maybe 15, 20 feet for birdie on the first hole here. I'm happy. Just to do a distance comparison on like how cold it is and how the temperature affects it. During the summer, I was hitting my 6 iron, that same 6 iron, 180 to 185, and flushing it, hitting it good. And then I hit flush. I mean, I was 167 to the pin, and you can say that that's about 167. So I flushed a 6 iron now, just about 5-6 weeks later, 167, and that's pushing it. I lied, I'm actually about 7-8 feet, not 15-20, but still a good, or maybe 10. But this is my favorite hole on the course, 450, so it's long, but it's downhill, so it probably plays like 420. It's dogleg left, so it's just my natural draw. It's a longer hole, so I like it. Ready to start, 1 under through 1. And favorite hole's out of the way. second hole here is a 373-yard par 4, dogleg right. Today it's into the wind, so I'm going to be hitting driver. It should leave me about 110. And got to start it up the left side with a fade. Down the middle, probably 250 up the fairway because it had a cut. And probably at 110, 120 into the pin.
So you can see Carl's ball there, in amongst all those white stakes. You guys can see it better than me. I'm battling to see it.
Alright, so I got 120 yards here, back pin. It's kind of into the wind, so I'm going to play a knockdown pitching wedge, long as dead. And it's been mats only, so I haven't been able to practice on the range with some crisp contact. But see how it goes. I think that's pin high again. Got another good look at birdie. About 8 feet again for birdie. Pretty sure my ball actually took a couple bounces and spun back, according to my perfect eyesight. Just kidding. So a nice start there, 2 under through two holes. These next three holes are probably the three toughest holes on the course, so get through those next three even. I'll be happy. So I got 212 yards. I'm gonna hit a choke down 5 wood because my three hybrid is being shipped from Niagara Falls because of a very weird situation, but I really need it on this course especially. I've never needed it so much. It just happens to be on this course where I need it the most. 212 yards. Gotta choke down on this 5 wood. 4 iron could get there if I nailed it, but it's too risky because I'm swinging it a lot harder, but this should be a good choice. Oh, yeah. So I missed the green long ways right, but I did manage to take the 30 yards that I needed off the club. In fact, I didn't even get to the green. So I gotta play a nice little flop shot up here and play for the right to left break. So I can get it close and make par. So I got about 6 feet here for par. Should be inside right. My putting has been a weakness lately. My stroke is different. I'm trying to work on it. But hopefully I can knock this one in. So I'm happy with a par there. 2 under through 3 holes. And that's just the first hole of the 3 hole really tough stretch. So this is a 605 yard par 5. Can't get there in 2, so I'm just gonna try hitting the fairway. Probably the tightest fairway on the whole entire course. It doglegs to the right and it's about 15 yards wide. Ball's going right in the rough. It was really a slice. Kind of cut across it, I guess. But it's my first bad drive of the day. I mean, it's still a 3-shot hole from there. It's not that bad. Hopefully it's not in the, hopefully it didn't get to the trees. So I missed the fairway a little right there. It's actually not that bad a miss. Oh, it is a bad a miss, but I got a kind of lucky break because it's a dogleg right. It's a severe dogleg right, but I'm off a cut lie. So it's gonna help me slice the ball around the trees. I also have a good lie, so I'm gonna be able to hit a 5-foot out of there and hopefully get it in play. I have about 150 in the green. There. I knew what to do. I knew exactly where I was trying to aim it. I just came straight right off the face. I didn't have the right kind of swing to put on it. Like, I know what to do to set up the shot. I didn't pull the shot off that I wanted to. It went straight right into the trees and I lost about 100 yards of distance. But I have 190 to the pin, to the back. I'm in the rough. So I'm gonna hit a 5-iron because it'll release out of this. Especially with a 5-iron, it usually draws out of this kind of lie. That should land just short of the green, or just on, and release all the way up to the back. Dead is long. Oh, I hit that flush. Settle.